Coming up on this week's Talk to Your Health, robotic surgery is having a huge impact on the lives of men suffering from prostate cancer. We'll show you how it works. Too many teens are still fighting obesity in this country. We'll tell you what simple things parents can do to make a difference. And a new study reveals how many of you are not washing your hands after using the restroom. That when I give you my second opinion. Hello and welcome to Talk to Your Health. I'm your host, Dr. Derek DeSilva. Prostate cancer is one of the most frequently diagnosed cancers in men. In fact, by year's end, 6,000 new cases of the disease will be diagnosed in our state, and more than 600 men will die. Technology has come a long way, though, including a type of robotic surgery being performed here in New Jersey that has several advantages over traditional surgery. Here to tell us about all it is Dr. Isaac Kim, Chief of Urologic Oncology at the Cancer Institute of New Jersey. And Ralph Stowe, a prostate cancer survivor who had successful surgery with this technology. Thank you both for being here today.
Thank you.
Dr. Kim, let's just get right into it. What is robotic surgery?
Well, robotic surgery is the latest surgical advances in treating patients with localized prostate cancer. Basically, there is a surgeon console in which I sit at and remotely control a unit which is sitting at the patient's bedside. And through a couple of small holes, I am manipulating the instrument to take the patient's prostate out.
Mm-hmm. Is this something that is easier to do? I mean, it sounds like working with this type of thing sounds a little bit more complicated. What are the advantages?
Well, the advantages is that it's much smaller incision, so the patients will be able to recover a lot quicker. For example, patients who are involved in, let's say, the desk work are routinely returned back to work within 2 weeks after surgery is done. Other advantages is that the blood loss is significantly lower. Transfusion rate at our institution over close to 700 cases now has been zero.
Mm-hmm. And I want to come back to some of the complications with over regular surgery and this procedure, but before we do that, what about you, Mr. Stowe, the whole idea of being diagnosed? How old were you? What happened? How did this happen?
I was 46 when I was diagnosed. It was a surprise to me because I didn't know that I had anything that growing in my body at that time. It was caught by a rise in my PSA.
Okay. So again, you know, and Dr. Kim, maybe you can comment on this, the need and still the importance for follow-up for, you know, African-American, Hispanic men who are at greater risk for prostate cancer, for prostate disease. Comment on the whole PSA issue.
Sure. You know, the thing is that with any cancer, prostate cancer, same thing. The best time to treat it is before it becomes symptomatic. Mm-hmm. So the way to get at this is to go through a series of screening studies to pick it up before the cancer spreads the patient's body. Now, there has been some controversies concerning what PSA really does to the patients. But what I tell all my patients is that at this point in time, PSA is the best test that we've got.
Right.
So to prevent and pick up prostate cancer, PSA is what you need right now.
Now, about what age? I mean, there are specific recommendations for checking the PSA. What are you telling your patients?
I tell my patients that we should get a baseline starting at age 40. And based on the base level, we'll adjust their follow-up period depending on the patient's risk factors.
Mm-hmm. Tell me a little bit about the surgery. You had this procedure done?
Yes, I did.
Describe it to us. Tell us what happened.
Well, it was really a quick procedure. Dr. Kim prepped me. I went to his to the area of where he practices, mm-hmm. and that's at Robert Wood Johnson. I simply, he told me just to relax. I even wanted to see my area of surgery before I was put to sleep. So he rolled me in there while I was still wide awake, and then when I went to sleep, when I woke up, it was done.
That's amazing. Advantages about with robotic surgery versus the regular traditional surgery?
So there is some controversy out there about the advantage of robotic surgery. That said, if you really look at the experiences of the surgeons who had more than a couple of the cases done now, the continence rate as well as the potency rate is a lot better.
Say that again. The incontinence?
The continence rate.
The continence, right.
And the potency rate.
Right.
Is a lot better with the robotics.
So people that have the robotic surgery, the incidence of losing your urine, the incidence of having problems with impotence or erectile problems is significantly less.
That's correct.
Why?
Again, because the camera comes at multiple different angles.
Mm-hmm.
Second thing, camera does give me a 10x magnification, so I'm able to better see the nerve bundles around the prostate. I believe that I'm able to do a much more precise dissection around the prostate, thus allowing for a less trauma to the nerve tissues around that area.
Your recovery, Ralph, how long after the surgery?
After the surgery, it took about maybe a little over a year for me to be at 100%.
But I'm talking about right after the surgery. Did you go back to work a week later?
Three weeks later, I was able to go back to work.
Okay. And now, what's going on with you now? Did you have to have other treatments? What happened?
Well, I had the surgery in 2008. Here we are in 2010.
Okay.
I am fully recovered, 100%. It took a while for my sexual functions to get at 100%.
Right.
With the help of medication. But now, without medication, I am back at home.
No problem.
Yes.
How many cases have you done?
695 cases now.
Wait, counting them? Since
yes.
You know the exact number, that's great. And you've been doing this a long time.
Yes.
Is that the take-home message here? Find somebody who's been doing this?
That is correct. Surgery, especially the results or the outcome, it really depends on the surgeon and who is doing that surgery. So you really want to find someone who's had the multiple or a couple hundred cases to have the outcome that you expect.
Super. Gentlemen, thank you for joining us. Pleasure to have you here. Folks, stay with us on 12 Day Health. Do you always wash your hands after going to the bathroom? Boy, I hope so. The results of a new secret study when I give you my second opinion. And after the break, what simple common sense steps patients can take to help fight teen obesity. And it's a serious problem. We'll tell you what you can do. But first, your health tip of the week. Beta carotene, a nutrient found in carrots, is thought to help prevent cancer. Here's some other foods that can help you get more out of it.